Hello everyone, Jennifer Maker here. A new version of Cricut Design Space for Desktop, version 7.29, is now in beta, and there's a fun new feature, the ability to warp text. It is so cool. Text warping gives you all of those fun waves and shapes you've seen in designs, but weren't able to do right in Cricut Design Space before this. So let me show you real quick how to make the most of this new feature. First, it's pretty simple to use. You need to be in the right version of Cricut Design Space, however. If your version does not say it's 7.29 or later, go to the three-line hamburger menu in the upper left corner, click on Settings, and change Application Experience to Beta. Then you can see this new feature. Now click on Text over on the left, type out a word. I'll type Welcome. And I'll change it to my personal handwriting font, Sweet. Okay, now all we have to do is go up to the new Warp option at the top of the screen and choose an option. At the time of making this video, there are 24 different warp styles. Click one and watch your text warp. Isn't this cool? There's so many different options here. Now, to do this in the past, you'd have to use a third-party application like Inkscape or Illustrator, save it as a SVG, and then import it. So this is a lot easier now. And you can combine different warp styles to create fun looks. So if I set this welcome to style 9, and then click text again and type out spring, and then warp spring to style 7, we can combine these two together and they fit so nicely. Then just add some color and you've got the start of a cool sign or sticker or whatever you want. Now here are some of the other fun designs that I've made already when I was playing with the warp feature. And this here is one of my favorites. I combined a free Star Wars font that I warped with style 17 and then added in some TIE fighters and X-Wings from a Star Wars digital mystery box that I got a while back. I think Greg is going to love this. It'll make a super cool shirt. Now it's important to note that your text remains editable after you warp it. So in this Be Kind design, I can double click on a text box, type a new word like rewind, and then click on the canvas to exit the editing mode. The text updates and the warp is applied to the new word, just like that. And that's how I got this warp, what is it good for? Absolutely something design. I'm not a singer. But you know that song, right? So let me show you exactly how I made that. First, I typed warp in all caps, changed it to a fun display font that I made called Groovy, and then I used style 1 to get this awesome effect. Note that this does look a bit different than if I simply curved it. Let's duplicate that so we can compare it. So to remove a warp effect, just go up to the warp menu and choose undo warp. It's that easy. You can always remove the warp effect on your text. So now let's curve this text and overlay it so you can see how it's just a little different. It's not a big deal with this particular warp style, but notice how the letters shape themselves more into the shape with the warp feature than they do with the curve feature. Okay, now let me show you a fun trick. Let's go back over to text and type two lines. What is it? The return key. Good for. And now we can apply a warp shape to this whole text block for a new effect. I will apply warp style 7 to this text, and then we get this effect. Isn't that groovy? Now the two lines are a little far apart, but good news, we can still reduce our line spacing with the menu at the top. I'll go for -3. And there we go. Awesome. And then to get the line at the bottom, again, I typed two lines. Absolutely something, and applied style 20, which reminds me of the credits in a Star Wars movie. Now that's cool, but the top line is a little hard to read. So let's choose a style with more room at the top, like style 23. If you want even less warpage, something you can do is edit the text and add a hard return at the top by positioning your cursor in front of the text and pressing return or enter on your keyboard. See how the warping is a little less obvious? Just a little tip. So a few things I want you to know about warp text. First, as I said, this is in beta only right now, so you'll need to be switched into the beta application experience to use this feature. But anyone can do that. Just go over to settings and switch it over to beta. Second, I've discovered that you can combine both warp and curve, but be aware that the results can be a little crazy and far out, but feel free to experiment and play. Third, you can also combine warp with resizing while the lock icon is off for some fun effects. Fourth, you can warp and flatten if you want to make print then cut designs like stickers. I think my welcome spring design would make a fun sticker too. Fifth, warp is only for single layer text and does not work for images, shapes, groups, or multi-layer fonts. So if you try to warp something and it doesn't work, check that you only have a single layer text object selected. Sixth, while warp text is a Cricut Access perk for subscribers, anyone can warp text on the screen, so feel free to play with it as much as you like. If you aren't a Cricut Access subscriber, you'll get an offer to sign up when you go to cut it. You can learn more about Cricut Access and its many benefits over at jennifermaker.com/Cricut Access. And if you're curious about the sweet handwriting font or the groovy font that I use for my designs in this video, you can learn all about how I made them and learn to make your own fonts at jennifermaker.com/fonts-workshop. If you have any questions about these Cricut Design Space changes, please leave a comment below this video and we'd be happy to help. I also invite you over to my fabulous Cricut Crafters group at jennifermaker.com/Cricut Crafters. This is a wonderful place to learn about new features and how to use them in your projects. And that's it for today. Until next time, this is Jennifer Maker reminding you to craft a life you love.